Now let's take a look at how CalEnviroScreen is being used both within CalEPA and outside of the agency. CalEnviroScreen is used by a number of different organizations in different ways. It is used to award grants, for enforcement of regulations, to fund projects that encourage sustainable development, and it can be used by communities and governments as they see fit. CalEnviroScreen was developed to identify places that have multiple sources of pollution and highly vulnerable populations. Having this information helps state agencies decide how to use their resources. The CalEnviroScreen tool can provide information about many of the factors that can contribute to impacts facing any area of California. The approach used by CalEnviroScreen allows anyone using the tool to compare different parts of the state. There are, however, a few limitations to CalEnviroScreen. For instance, CalEnviroScreen cannot tell how likely you are to experience pollution-related health effects or other environmental impacts. CalEnviroScreen is also not a substitute for the cumulative impacts assessment required by the California Environmental Quality Act, or CEQA. In 2012, the governor signed into law Senate Bill 535 as part of the state's greenhouse gas reduction plan to fund projects in disadvantaged communities. SB 535 directed CalEPA to identify disadvantaged communities in the state based on geographic, socioeconomic, public health, and environmental hazard information. More recently, the governor signed into law Assembly Bill 1550, which increased the percent of funds for projects located in disadvantaged communities from 10 to 25%. CalEPA has designated the disadvantaged communities as those census tracts falling within the highest 25% of CalEnviroScreen scores. CalEnviroScreen is being used for a variety of other programs as well. Greenhouse gas reduction funds are being used for low-carbon transportation projects, weatherization projects, affordable housing projects, and urban green space and forestry. For example, the Strategic Growth Council, a state government program that supports sustainable communities, provides funds to CalEnviroScreen disadvantaged communities through planning grants. The Active Transportation Program of the California Department of Transportation, or Caltrans, funds projects that make bicycling and walking safer and encourage use of public transit. CalEnviroScreen is being used to identify disadvantaged communities for priority funding. CalEPA is made up of a number of boards, departments, and offices. Several of these are currently using the tool in their work. For example, the Department of Toxic Substances Control uses CalEnviroScreen to find disadvantaged communities that are disproportionately burdened, so the department can prioritize responding to their complaints and conduct inspections. CalEPA's Environmental Justice Small Grant Program helps eligible nonprofit community groups and tribal governments address environmental justice issues and incorporate information from CalEnviroScreen into their decision-making. The agency's Environmental Justice Task Force has also used CalEnviroScreen to identify disproportionately impacted areas for compliance assistance in enforcement efforts. CalEPA uses CalEnviroScreen to direct outreach and training for community groups and state and local government organizations. In addition to the uses we've described, CalEnviroScreen is being used by other programs to identify disadvantaged and burdened communities. These communities will receive services and assistance that might not otherwise be available. Programs include California Energy Commission's activities under the Green Tariff Shared Renewables Program and the Department of Toxic Substances Control's responsibilities under new hazardous waste regulations. Senate Bill 43 directs renewable energy projects to disadvantaged communities identified by CalEnviroScreen. Under Assembly Bill 1329, the Department of Toxic Substances Control prioritizes enforcement in communities identified by CalEnviroScreen. CalEnviroScreen is being used by other state and local agencies as well, and by community groups and individuals.